different form. Beyond any meaning we can assign to happiness. A past experience revived in the meaning is not the experience of one life only, but of many generations. Not forgetting something that is probably quite
takes place at the back of the neighborhood. was fire from a fiddle, the fiend of the fell.
I have played in my time every possible part, and I used to know 70 speeches by heart. I'd extemporize back chat. I knew how to gag, and I knew how to let the cat out of the bag. I knew how to act with my back and my tail. With an hour of rehearsal, I never would fail. I'd a voice that would soften the hardest of hearts, whether I played the lead or in character part. I have sat by the bedside of poor little Nell when the curfew was rung. Then I swung on the bell. In the pantomime season, I never fell flat, and I once understudied Dick Whittington's cat. But my grandest creation, as history will tell, was fire from Fiddle, Fiend of the Fell.
Then if someone will give him a toothful of gin, he will tell how he once played a part in East Lynne. At a Shakespeare performance, he once walked on pat when some actors suggested the need for a cat.
And I say now, these kittens, they do not get trained as we did in the days when Victoria reigned. They never get drilled in the regular troop, and they think they are smart just to jump through a hoop.
And he says, as he scratches himself with his claws,
well, the theater is certainly not what it was. These modern productions, they're all very well, but there's nothing to equal, from what I hear tell, that moment of mystery when I made history. Fire from Fiddle, the Fiend of the Fell.
Thank you.
proud and implacable, passionate foes. It is always the same wherever one goes. And the punks and the poms, although most people say that they do not like fighting, yet once in a way they will now and again join into the fray. And they bark, 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 until you can hear them all over the park. And they the occasion of which I shall speak, almost nothing had happened for nearly a week, and that's a long time for a paw or a beak. The big police dog was away from his beat. I don't know the reason, but most people think he slipped into the Wellington Arms for a drink, and no one at all was about on the street when a pink and a polycle happened to meet. They did not advance or exactly retreat, but they glared at each other and scraped their hind feet and started to
bark, 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 bark,
until you can hear them all over the park. Now the pink, although people may say what they please, is no British dog but a heathen Chinese. And so all the pinks, when they heard the uproar, some came to the window, some came to the door. There were surely a dozen, more likely a score, and together they started to grumble and wheeze in their puffery, snuffery, heathen Chinese. But a terrible day is what a polycle's like, for your polycle dog is a Yorkshire tyke. And the pugs and the poms are no longer aloof, but some from the balcony, some from the roof, join into the din with a together assembled, the traffic all stopped and the underground trembled.
And some of the neighbors were so much afraid that they started to aim up the fire brigade. When suddenly up from a small basement flat, why Hoosiers stalk out the parade, the parade.
My eyes were like fireballs fearfully blazing. I gave a great yawn, and my jaws were amazing. And when I looked out through the bars of the area, you never saw anything.